that company even is more for people like Metro D. Because Western Digital is, I'm sure, registered mark on the Philippines. Under the IP code, I'm sure it's registered. So, in other words, if you're the complainant, you're more likely to get a complaint.
I agree. Given these laws, my question is, what makes for good disclaimer in laws? Because bloggers usually have these disclaimers or legal in their pages. So what should be included there now?
That's a good question. I think we're, you know, that's a very, very good question. I mean, when you talk about, say, data privacy, for example, the best that you can do is get the consent. But remember, if you just put it in your terms of use and there's no click through to accept those terms, then it's not binding on the users. Your disclaimer in your blog. But if I visit your blog and I don't click to accept those disclaimers, in other words, you have no proof that I gave my consent to those terms because they're just passive, right? There's a link on your page. Then that's not binding on me. What's binding on me are terms and conditions that, you know, window comes up and just click here to accept. Okay? Hindi binding yung sasabihin mo in your blog. When you visit my blog, the mere fact that you visited my blog, you're bound by these terms and conditions. That is not binding. What is binding is you have to show that they gave their consent to the terms and conditions. Okay? But even then, even if you get the consent under the data privacy law, there are certain things like the rights of users, right, that they cannot bargain away. In other words, that's the funny thing about our law. Under the EU Data Protection Directive, this is the 1997 directive in the EU, if you can get the consent of the data subject, then you can do whatever you want with their data. In other words, you can contract. You can contract away your privacy. Right? In other words, we do that all the time. When you fill out a form for a raffle in your grocery, you're freely giving away your data. Right. In exchange for the possibility of winning that prize. So, in the EU Data Privacy Directive, if they tell you that we were going to use this data and sell it to others, so long as it's upfront and you know your rights, you can contract it away. And you won't have rights to your data. Under Philippine law, it seems that there are minimum rights that are yours and you're not allowed to contract them away. Now, rights of one person are obligations of others. In other words, if you're processing that information, you have to respect the rights of those people. Otherwise, they may charge you with a crime.
But the thing is, we already have a database of content where you have pictures of people, of our students. So what do you mean to say? Do I have to call each and every person on every photo just to get their consent so I can publish it?
My answer to that question is yes. What's needed, I think, here is you have to be sensitive about what personal information is. But people don't realize what personal information is, right? But once you explain to them what personal information is, for me, it's kind of mind-blowing because you have no idea. If somebody tells you something in the morning when you wake up, that's personal information. Right? I mean, it's not personal information. It's personal information when you get consent. You know, but unless you write down, they get in jail. And this is the stuff of social media. The stuff of social media is, hey, look at this guy. This is what he's doing. Or see what's going on with this guy. So if you're the one who did it, that's fine. That's you. But what if you bring in other people? Here I am, in SMX. So now, it's not just my private data, it's hers also. So when you start thinking along these lines, it's really confusing. I mean, one problem that I think they didn't think about was the Roman Catholic Church. I mean, hindi tayo magpadasal. Ano na yun? That's health information. Hindi ka na pwede magpadasal. Your disclosure to him is a crime, right? His receipt of it is a crime. When he sent it on the announcing, to other people para makilasaw sila, please pass him on that 20% information. You laugh, but you know the reason why I found this out? Until about 8 years ago in the US, they passed HIPAA, the Health Information Privacy. So they protect the health information. So I went to church. And then I saw the form. Diba? Sabi parang, gusto mo magpadasal, sige, sulat mo yung pangalan, health condition, at kung ito ay health condition, please have the person sign the consent form in the back. Okay? Without concern for something
else.
Whatever we
did
get consent for, we have to
delete. Well, you know, you have to look at the information. You will talk about, sabi nila, ex post facto. Laws are not supposed to apply retroactively, right? But the thing about, when you look at the definition of processing, making available, I think, is processing. That's the problem. Processing of any operation about personal information, limited collection, recording, organization, updating, modification, consultation, use, very important. Eh, kasi na-app ko na siya, so na-post ko na siya, na-process ko na, di ba? But aren't you still using it now? The fact that it's on your side? Are you not using that personal information? Aren't you? Right? Oh. That's the problem. Funny, you saw the same thing. No, the major word here, the major word is use. Right? Use is very broad. So when you put it on your account, it's there, you're publishing it now. Are you not using it? So even assuming that you can argue your way around, the fact that there's doubt means that if you're conservative, you stop. If you want to fight it out, then you leave it on. That's the problem with rules. We're constrained by language. If the language is not very clear, it's not finely, if you don't design it with attention to detail, you might be overstepping boundaries. So with the data privacy law, I think they were not, you know, there's a provision here in fact. Do you know that you're dead, you still have privacy rights? I thought that was absurd. I think if you're dead, there's nothing private about you anymore. After all, what reason could there be to protect your privacy after you're dead? Although we might put an exception to Philippine presidents, to the extent that we don't want to blacken their name after they're dead. I think the provisions in the intellectual property code to that effect. But there's a provision here that says that even dead people, the information on dead people, they have rights that can be asserted by their heirs. Oh. So my grandfather died 50 years ago. You're processing his information by putting his picture on FB. I'm asserting his right to privacy. Did you get his consent? That's a good question. No, I can't have any consent. The heirs, which heirs? Right? Great-grandfather, majority. These are questions that the privacy law, it's really, there are ways around it, but as I said, I mean, one big hole in this law is when it comes to personal information. Let's go back to the section. Sorry to be technical here. I want you to see the provision. Section 12. So, sabi nito, the processing of information shall be allowed, shall be permitted, when at least one of the following conditions exists. So, consent, hindi ka nakapag-consent, hindi ka pasok dyan. Right? So, ito yung last. The processing, meaning the use disclosure, is necessary for legitimate interests pursued by you. You're the person information controller. Okay? Now, unless those rights are protected under the Constitution. Which again is confusing. But the following thing here is, what is meant by legitimate interest? Right? So long as you can prove that your interest is legitimate, then you can say, I don't need to get your consent, I can process your information. The question is, what's legitimate and what's not? Right? So, actually, when you think about this actually vetoes the whole law, doesn't it? Because you would always say, my use of information is legitimate. Isn't marketing a legitimate purpose? Isn't marketing a good thing? Giving information to consumers? Information that may be useful for them to make informed choices about what things to buy or what information is out there, that's good for them, that's good for everyone, right? That's not a bad thing. So you see, that's a legitimate purpose. The problem here is that, since we don't know right now what is legitimate, what is legitimate, and since the purpose of the law is to protect privacy, they need to tell us what legitimate interests are. Because if they don't tell us what legitimate interests are, if you take a very broad view of what legitimate interests are, then you're not protecting privacy. You might as well not have a look. Right? If you say anything is justifiable, then wala nang privacy. We're back to square one. And this is such a long statute. We went through all the troubles, I am not.